Hey, Saidu here. Now in this video I'll be showing you how you can explore processes, threads, undo and even Windows Registry. Now I'll be using a program called Process Explorer. So you can go ahead and check it from their website here. I'll put the download link in the description box below. Now you can check it using you can download the single application, the Process Explorer, or you can go ahead and download the entire suite that contains almost every software or application that is here. So I've already downloaded this, so it's a zip file. As you can see, I already have it on my system. So I'll go ahead and launch this application. I save it in my download, compress. So look at the unzip folder. Now let me locate my Process Explorer. So it's here. Double click to open. Now if you are running this application for the first time, it will ask you to accept this end user license agreement. So I will click on agree to continue. So yeah, this is the window of the Process Explorer. It does have nice window, as you can see from here. It does have different pins that house your process, your CPU, your memory, your process ID description, and even the company name. Now the sweet thing about this application is I know most of the things that I'll be discussing here you can be able to do it using Windows Task Manager, but this one is on another level, I would say that. So you do have your process, you do have each parent process, you have the child process. For example, the system, you have your interrupts running on the system, meaning the system is the parent process and interrupt is the child process. So it does have nice GUI. We'll be showing you how you can save maybe after exploring the entire processes. You feel confident that your system is running smoothly, so you can decide to save the current system performance, maybe use it in the future as a baseline of your system performance. So you can save it as a TXT file with whatever name you decide to save it. Now scrolling down through all of this process might be tedious sometimes because you do have a lot of processes that are running. So but what you do is, if for example you want to know where you want to locate a specific process, all you need to do is to hold this button here and grab it to whatever process you want to check. So for example, I'm trying to check this explorer. Look at my explorer.exe. It does have other child processes under it. I have this torrent, but let me go ahead and use my C command prompt as an example. So here, let's try and use this command prompt. So you hold this button, drag it over to the command prompt. So it will highlight this process inside this process explorer. There you see the CMD, which is a parent process, and the conhost.exe as a child process. So this will tell you how much CPU this particular process is consuming, the memory, the working set, and it does have a description. From here you can see that this one is a Windows command processor. So I also have a company that has this command cmd.exe, which is Microsoft in this case. So another cool feature of this process explorer is you can maybe trace for virus. So for example, if you do have a process or an application running on your system and you don't feel confident about it, or you feel suspicious about that particular process, you can decide to check for viruses. Maybe the application is consuming a lot of system resources, and you know you as the administrator, you did not start this application, and it is not a system program. So you can decide to just check for the virus using this, you just right click, go to check virus total. So this will submit a hash to virus total website. So it has done. Now I'll just have to click this virus total number to take me to their site. So I go to my browser. This is the result of the virus total. So what you are seeing here is that virus check total has used these engines, different kind of engines, to check for malicious or virus in that particular software, which is on host. So it has used all these engines, and all these engines reported back as undetected. That is, they didn't find any virus in that particular application. So had even that application or process is malicious, so you see here will turn out to be red instead of green. So but this is it. You can even go further to check for the details. You can check the history, you can check the basic properties, which this one is the message, MD5 hash message of that particular program. You can check the names, you can check the signature information, which in this state, this file does not have, this file is not signed. But you can see the product company, you can see the description, which is console, Windows, host, and all that. So another thing is you can be able to check this community. So what this community is trying to do is they will just report based, just like a summary. They will give a kind of summary based on the report on their website. So for example, this con host that we are checking, so they will just provide you with a report on that particular program, why it's not malicious and all that. So let's go back to our process explorer here. So from this process explorer, you can right click to kill the process. Maybe if you find the process malicious or is consuming a lot of your system resources, you can just click and kill the process from here. For example, let's do it. I want to have it currently. Let me bring out my command. Let me bring out my command prompt so that I want it to be on the same window. So now I want to right click. So let me just highlight this again. So I will right click on this CMD and ask to kill the process. So this one will just kill the process immediately. So another thing that you can do, let me bring back my CMD. So another thing that you can check is the properties of a particular process. So right now this is the thread properties of that particular program. You can see the thread ID. So each thread do have a thread ID and all that. You will see the thread ID, you see the start time and the state of that particular ID. But right now this one is in write queue. So this one will just give you an overview of what that particular process is doing on your system. So you can see now another feature of this process explorer is this. So this one will just give you a kind of graphical representation of what is happening in your system. Maybe this will just give you a summary of your system resources usage by these processes. So you do have tabs that you can use to go over CPU, memory, and IO, GPU, and other. So that is that. Okay, this lower pane show you right now it is in the handle mode. So this one is just showing you, if you click on a particular process right here, it will change depending on where this particular program or process is pointing to. So right now this is the handle here of this particular host. So let's right click this and bring it again and say right click kill process, and that's all. So that virus checks stuff is very, very useful if you want to check for malicious activity on your computer. So another thing that I want to show you is how to use the Windows registry. So you just go to your start menu and type red edit. So let me quickly explain this, as this is not a full tutorial on Windows Registry, but let me just quickly show you what is happening here. So the first one here, it does have kind of five hives or section. So the first folder here stores, so Windows Registry is basically a hierarchical database that stores system and software configuration on your system. So the first one here is hkey_classes_root. What this does is it stores all the extensions in your system. So the other one is the current user, which store all the configuration of this system configuration of this system configuration of this particular user, the user that into the system. So the other one is the local machine. This one house all the configuration settings on that particular machine, of that particular machine. So the other one is user. This one stores all the system configuration of other users apart from the every user account configured on this system. This is where it's being stored. So the other one is the current configuration, that is the configuration that is currently running on the system. But what I want to show you is this. Now if we go to this current user, go to software, and let's try and locate our sys internal software from here. So here it is. So let me go to this process explorer. So if you remember before we launched the process explorer, I did accept a user license agreement. So now I want to revoke that acceptance. So right now it is showing true in this value data because I have already accepted the user license agreement. So if I want to revoke that acceptance, I will just change this to zero, and if I try to open it again, it will not be like, I'm opening it for the first time. So if I go to this folder, try to launch this. So look at the application is still asking me to agree to the user license. So that is what I wanted to show you quickly. So somebody might said, so the whole idea of this process idea is to give the system or cybersecurity analyst that privilege of knowing what is running on the system, what is consuming more resources. If a particular program is suspicious, the system analyst can be able to trace back to check the virus total report to see what is happening, if that system is truly malicious or is not. So that is that. And if you do like this kind of, if you enjoyed this video, like it. And if you do like this kind of content, you want this kind of content, please consider subscribing. And I will see you in the next one.